You know, people were wondering when did Elaine shut down her season. I might say shut down her season for what, right? She's under a new coach and things went wrong. So you're gonna shut things down and not try to figure out what went wrong and get it right before the season ends so that you can go into next season knowing to, okay, I did what I do wrong, I could do it that way and next year kind of thing. Moving on to the last but certainly not least Jamaican, our little goodie, you know, Elaine Thompson here. No phone, obviously, I'm biased towards Elaine still, but it is what it is. Elaine is from Manchester. I'm always going to forever support her in her endeavors. Now, Elaine not having what her best season this year, right? Now, she would have gone to the World Championships and she would have gotten a bronze. So, what can we really expect from Elaine in this race? I am thinking that we may see some redemption. Why? Okay, we saw what happened in Eugene. But what I took away from Eugene more than anything else is that Elaine was not race fit. Those three rounds of the 200 really showed. It wasn't that Elaine wasn't fast enough to get on the medal podium. Hell yeah, she was fast enough to get on the medal podium. But she wasn't, her body wasn't ready to handle all those rounds. That's pretty much what I took away from Eugene. Fast forward to the Commonwealth Games. I did mention this in the in the 100 meter hurdles preview video that the conditions were not so good, and for Toby to run so fast was, for me, was fantastic. So the same applies to Elaine, right? The conditions, they were really cold. We saw her in long sleeves sometimes, wiping her nose sometimes. That's how, you know, chilly it was. And more so than anybody else, I think it would affect Jamaicans that, you know, train locally the weather. We've seen it happen with Shelly already in I think it's the same place actually. When she ran with Shakira and Dina, right? It was horrible, horrible weather, right? So Jamaicans tend to not necessarily perform that well in these conditions. So for me, at the time, I didn't really focus on the time because I'm like, I understand the conditions. It's really cold. And athletes will say, and I've heard athletes say that, listen, what they feel when it's cold is like their body's stiff and it's cold. So you won't be as fluid as you want to be, right? So that said, though, onto the 200 meters. The 200 meters is what got my eyes lifted because I'm like, okay, three rounds of the 100 meters down. Let's see if you're able to hold up for three rounds of the 200. Granted, the competition is not as stiff as it would have been in the World Championships, but some of these girls are still running world class times, and I loved Elaine's progression in each round. Now onto the finals. I've always talked about Elaine's bend in the 200 meters, and I was so happy to see Elaine blaze that bend because I remember in Eugene the moment. Trackies, I'm not lying to you. The moment Elaine got up out of the blocks, I knew she was not going to challenge Sharik or Shelly for any of those places that were 1-2, right? Because her bend was so slow, right? Well, before we got to the bend, just her first 50 for me was just not it, right? But I loved what I saw in the Commonwealth Games. It showed me that, yes, she's getting back in shape, and I love it. And, you know, people were wondering, why did Elaine shut down her season? I might say shut down her season for what, right? She's under a new coach and things went wrong. So you're gonna shut things down and not try to figure out what went wrong and get it right before the season ends so that you can go into next season knowing to, okay, I did what I do wrong, I could do it that way and next year kind of thing. So obviously, in my opinion, quite rightly so, Elaine is still running because they need to figure things out this season. right? Whatever went wrong needs to be figured out this season so that come next season, we say, okay, that would do wrong. I saw if you do it kind of thing. So what I saw at the Commonwealth Games gives me hope that in this particular race, Elaine will be able to redeem herself against Shelly and obviously Sharika. Now, part of the reason as well, and it's not really a big, big reason, but, you know, we saw that video of her running 10-3 something in practice. So I didn't really focus on what the time that was being shown, but the how the Elaine looked in that video. And that Elaine is starting to look like the Elaine of old. And by Elaine of old, we mean Elaine last year. So it's not really that long ago, but the Elaine last year, that's the Elaine that I saw coming to fore in that video. And I'm like, okay, girl's gonna come up, girl's gonna show up, and she's going to perform really well. So in this race, I'm expecting somewhat of a redemption for Elaine. Now, we saw her run 10-8 in Eugene. So a redemption is not going to be 10-5, guys. I don't expect Elaine to run 10-5 in this race. No. I'm expecting Elaine to do run a competitive 10-7 low or hopefully break into 10-6. Now, that 10-6 there, hold that with a grain of salt. But I'm expecting her to run a really competitive 10-7. Why am I saying a competitive 10-7? Because if I'm expecting Sharika, who is at her best right now, to run a 10-6, and Shelly obviously being someone that's obviously at her best as well, right? I am saying Elaine is not at her best. So I'm not expecting her to challenge or be running, you know, those super, super fast times just yet, that is. But I'm seeing the progression. So I'm expecting a 10-7 low. And you know what? Elaine being Elaine, I hope she can surprise me, because what she tends to do a lot of times is surprise. Because as I did say, she doesn't give a lot away when she's running. So a lot of times you have to be trying to read other things to try to figure out if she's going to be running her best, right? So with all of that said and all this rambling, and I don't know where this video is going to end up, but I'm hoping to see Elaine run a low 10-7. In this particular race. That said, trackies, as usual, sound off in the comment section below and let me know, what are you expecting from Elaine Thompson-Herra in this race? Can she redeem herself and challenge Shelly and Sharika for a top spot there? Or, you know, what is your expectation? Sound off in the comment section below. And as usual, like the video and subscribe.